Hey guys, Chris Fix here. Today I'm going to show you how to use a multimeter to test the battery on your car to see if it's bad. Some symptoms that you could have with a bad battery or a bad alternator is that your battery light is on the dash, the engine's cranking slowly or not cranking at all, there's clicking when you turn the engine on but the engine doesn't start so it just clicks, the battery seems weak or is dead, the interior lights or headlights seem weak, and stuff like that. These symptoms could be a bad battery or alternator. This video right now is going to focus on the bad battery aspect of it. To see the alternator tests, watch my other video. The link to that video is in the description below. One of the first ways you could tell if your battery is going bad is you put your key in the ignition, you turn it to the run position, and you can see, right there is the battery light. That lets you know that the battery light is working. Most cars test the voltage of the battery through the battery light, so if that blows out, you won't be able to tell if your battery is bad or not. And a lot of times that could trigger another light, like a check gauges light. So what should happen is when you start the car, it'll shut off. If it shuts off, then your battery is good.
To test the battery, what you want to do first is you want to turn the headlights on for about 2 minutes. This will get rid of any surface charge the battery may have. As we wait, what you want to do is you want to turn on your voltmeter, and right now I have it set to ohms. You want to set it to 20 volts or something above 15 volts. So 20 is what my voltmeter has, and that's ready to go. 2 minutes later, we're going to shut the lights off and make our way over to the battery. This is our positive lead, and this is our negative lead. Our negative is our ground. Now I'm going to connect our red to our red, and our black to our black, and you can see the voltage goes to 12.85. You want to have around 12.6 volts. So this is good. Now just because this is a good voltage doesn't mean your battery's good. The battery could be holding a charge but doesn't have the cold cranking amps to start the car. But that's what we're going to test right now. So I'm going to go start the car with these attached, and this shouldn't drop below 10. If this drops below 10, then we have a battery problem. You can see it dropped down, and then it popped back up, and now it's at 14. That's because the alternator is charging the battery. Now you saw this dropped down to about 10, 10.5, and rose right back up. So that's good. This battery checks out, has enough cranking amps, and the cells are good. And I knew this. This battery is good. I'm just showing you as a test of what should happen. If this drops down below 10, then your battery's starting to go. Below 5, your battery's garbage. You need a new battery. Cold cranking amps, CCA, is the measurement of how many amps a battery can deliver at 0 degrees Fahrenheit for 30 seconds and not drop below 7.2 volts. Batteries are supposed to last about 4 years, and that's what most of them are warranted to, but only 30% of the batteries that are sold today reach that 4-year mark. Now, if you are having problems with your battery and this doesn't solve it, you also want to see to make sure your connections here aren't corroded. You can see here, there's a little bit of corrosion, but nothing bad. What you might want to do is get some sandpaper, some WD-40, sand it up. If there's corrosion on here, you see like this blue-green crystalline stuff, you want to make sure you use goggles and gloves because that stuff is corrosive. It could hurt your hands and it could hurt your eyes. You can see that these terminals are actually pretty clean. Obviously, I told you I had no problem with this car, but let's check out a battery with bad terminals that are dirty. So here's a good example of what I was talking about. And if that happens, you want to clean off your battery terminals really good. So I have a piece of sandpaper, and that'll do the trick. You just loosen this up. And once you get all that dirt and everything out of here, just sand the post down. So you can see I cleaned the post off pretty good. Clean the inside of this very good, so they attach. Slide that back on. We'll tighten this completely with a ratchet. The other battery terminal is done as well. That looks good. So I'm going to tighten them up, and then we'll take a reading. Now I know this battery is going to be low, but this will give you an idea of a bad battery. 2 volts. That's bad. This battery is garbage. It's 6 years old, and it can't even hold a charge anymore. I charged the battery last night to 12.6 volts, and now it's 2 volts. I kept the terminals disconnected to make sure there wasn't any draw from the car. So that's an example of what a bad battery looks like.
One more thing. After you're done cleaning off the posts, hit it with some WD-40, and that'll prevent it from rusting and getting corroded again.
So we're going to look at one more battery. This is my truck battery. This battery is 6 years old, and you can see it's perfect. 12.7 volts. So I ran the headlights for about 2 minutes. Now we're going to see what happens when we start it up. This battery is running really strong. You saw it dropped down to 11 volts when I was starting it. And the alternator is running well, and it's going to 14.25 while it's running. That is excellent. So you saw 2 good batteries and 1 bad battery. The 1 bad battery wouldn't even be able to start a car.
These batteries that I showed you in this video are all maintenance-free batteries. They don't need any water. If you have a battery that needs water, you'll see they'll have caps up here. And you want to make sure that they're not filled to the top of the cap, but they're a quarter of an inch over the electrode, the metal piece that's inside there. And if you need to fill it with bottled water or distilled water, so you don't have any extra minerals or anything that's in your water getting into the lead-acid battery. The other thing you should remember is that you could take your car to a major parts store and they'll test your battery for free. They have better equipment that will thoroughly test this, and you get a good idea how much life is left in your battery. If this video was helpful, give it a thumbs up. Also consider subscribing. I publish how-to videos weekly. I answer all the YouTube comments and questions you guys leave, and watching these videos will teach you something new and hopefully save you some money. And on the screen you'll see different videos that have to do with the battery system, including the how to test the alternator video. That video goes really well with this. It'll give you a good idea after you test your battery to go test your alternator. And finally, check out the Chris Fix Facebook and Twitter pages with the links in the description below.